Morning everyone, welcome back to the channel. Let's do a little recap then on Saturday. Well, we did give you the short one yesterday. It was a maximum win bet in the shape of Diego Velasquez. And Diego Velasquez proved to be the superstar before it was absolutely hacked up. And words that I only knew it was in a race come the final furlong, etc., are always nice to hear after debut runs. So we knew how much work the horse had done, and it was very little. We knew how exciting that work had been though, and we knew Diego would get the business done, and we knew to get on for the 2,000 guineas beforehand as well. So that's all done. You can currently still get it around 8-1, but you're still 16-1 at the moment. And I'm not really a big anti-post punter myself, but I always do like to steal a few quid early on in the year where I get told what ones are better horses, and I have done that for the last 7 or 8 years. And it's always paid off for me. Obviously, injuries are the main concern. The horse will go for the 2,000 guineas. I know they're talking about the Derby. And yes, the Derby will be where the horse will be heading to eventually. But it will run the month before in the 2,000 guineas. And they expect it to be their one that day. Speaking about the Derby, I'm going to give you another horse that they have mentioned as well. And this one, I know Diego is round about 12-1 for the Derby, so you could bet that just now anti-post if he's won. Obviously, you don't need to go mad at 12-1 anyway. But I'm going to give you another horse that they have mentioned that will be going for the Derby. And this horse is a very, very good animal. Again, no one really knows about it, but we do. So, this horse is called London City. It is 50-1 for the Derby. So, if you have a little small dabble at that in the anti-post market, wouldn't be surprised to see this one hitting the frame. But Diego is definitely their best horse. That's for sure, the best one they have. This year we're told, obviously horses can improve as 3-year-olds, some horse could come in. Power ahead of a couple of the bigger names down the line, but at the moment Diego is the best they have in the yard. So if he's back, if he's around that for the 2,000, he should be okay. And back it obviously for the Derby, and back London City as well at a massive price. That's two each way bets. She's going to have around 12s and 50-1. You wouldn't go wrong there. Those who were in party, who were involved in the tartan bet yesterday, a bit disappointed with the first runner. I did actually send a text out after that race. I was annoyed, but I got a text back saying, hold your horses, the next one wins, don't worry about that. So that kind of covered the day when it bolted up heavily backed. But I wanted more from yesterday for these, and these turned out in big numbers. But today we have got a treble there, which is over 225-1 at the moment. Obviously, the quicker you get in, the better odds you'll get, because these horses will be smashed up today. But we've got a horse we gave these out, and it won at 33-1. Along with a horse that is around 91 at the moment, that the trip is ideal for today. Expected to run a massive race. And we've got a horse in there around 61 that should be heavily involved in the finish. Obviously, the possibly speaking of, won the last time at 33-1 for us. It's not 33-1 today though, sadly. But still got a massive chance at a nice price. So you can get yourselves involved in those three by clicking on the link below. £4 gets you involved in that, guys. I'm going to give these a bet out from Leicester at the moment. And this horse runs in the 2.58 race then. It's horse number 4, Kingdom of Riches. And it is currently 5-4, the best price I can see, guys. It's a maximum win bet for the main line on the Sunday. And let's hope Kingdom of Riches puts more riches into everyone's bank accounts later on this afternoon then. Yeah, let's have a cracking end to the week. It's been a bit up and down, obviously, weather-wise, and that has had a little effect on the results. We've had a few cracking days, we've had a few not-so-cracking days, but let's end it on a high and make sure we end on a profitable week then, as we like to do every week then. Have a cracking Sunday, guys, whatever you're doing. Take care, enjoy it, and let's hope it's a profitable one. Cheers.